Well, then Savitri sits in the middle of these two sort of screwball comedies.
Yeah, it's not the same job.
And it's sort of a different animal, is he not? Sitting there in the middle in a way. Mr. Holst.
The thing, well, why don't you, I mean, talk about this amazing sound world of Holst.
Well, it's a beautiful opera. It's this mixture between no orchestra at all and just hearing things from different parts of the room, from different colors. And then when the orchestra sometimes comes in and enters, it's just, you know, it's two flutes, just playing a sustained chord. You go, what is happening here? But he shifts harmonically, and he plays with colors, and then the orchestra starts narrating, and then we prepare for an entrance of a new character. But it's this weird sound world that's shifting between this very thinly veiled orchestra to almost Wagnerian sections. You know, Holst was really influenced by Wagner early on, and while he was kind of past that when he wrote this opera, you still hear this idea of leitmotifs all over the place.
Parsifal and Ziegfeld.
Absolutely. But, you know, one of the main characters in Savitri is death. And Peter, I hope you talk about a little bit about how death is being portrayed in the opera, but it's not a scary thing necessarily, but when you hear it, you know death is somewhere in the room because Holst is writing for it. It's rumbling underneath. And even though the singer might be singing something that's totally related, once you hear death's theme come back, you know, oh, something's going to be there. Death's around.
Well, I mean, what we're doing is I did not feel comfortable again. This is just a personal choice. And 10 years ago, I might have felt different about this. But you know, it's an Indian tale, and it is an important Indian tale. But I am not an expert on things Indian, and I, you know, the whole demon of cultural appropriation is with us these days. So I have turned this into a woman who has survived World War I in approximately 1923, who is trying to move forward, and that's all I'll say about that. But basically, during the course of the opera, she is visited. One of the people she's visited by is death, and the other is her husband. And we'll just leave it at that for now. But we'll just say that both are appropriately garbed for what they would have been doing during World War I.